Hey, what's up, my cool like dad peeps? It is me, your cool like dad Asian, in the house. Yes, it is. I am actually going to give you my reviews before tonight. Because I have to, in about an hour, I have to be at work. But I just wanted to give you my reviews and post it so you guys all know. Last week, I had over 700 people view that video of me giving a review. I had some negative feedback, which wasn't very nice. And, you know, and which I understand, but, you know, calling people gay, fag, you know, that's not a good thing. So you guys knock that shit off, okay? But anyways, I'm going to give you my feedback. My feedback is, so we're going to go down the line. Bond Smith, All I Need to Get By, he has strong vocals, but basically, I don't know if he has that connection that I'm looking for. He doesn't really connect, and that's a big problem for me. I'm not too sure if he's going to make it through. Great vocals, though. Taylor Vaifanua, blah, blah. I should get used to this. If I Ain't Got You, she's very forgettable. She did start off rocky, and my roommate and I was watching, and she does these unnecessary movements in the beginning, which is not very good. But I really liked her in the beginning. I'm not too sure what happened this round. She just didn't pick a right song for her. Alex Wagner-Trugman, this is why they call it blues. This guy is such a dork. Such a dork. But, you know, I really could not look at him while he was singing. I don't know what it was. I think it was just too much of the animated factor. If you close your eyes, he has a good voice, but when you look at him, it just doesn't make up for it. Yeah. Ariana Asfar, whatever her name is, The Winner Takes It All. I love this song from Mamma Mia, by the way, but this song did make her sound a little older, and she should have picked something that was closer to her age and her range and everything. She has a good voice, I got a very strong voice, but she just didn't pick the right song for it. Junot Joyner, Hey There Delilah, he sounds good, kind of boring in the beginning, but he really did do something different with it and made it more his style, and that's what made it awesome. But he didn't get, I don't think he got too much of airtime, so I'm not too sure if he's going to get a lot more. Kristen McNamara, Give Me One Reason. This girl has a strong voice. I love the slight rockage she has, but I'm not too sure she's losing that. And hopefully they bring her back for to show off her talent a little bit more and show that range that she has. She's great. Next one is Nathaniel Marshall. I Would Do Anything for Love. Oh, this guy is so drama. I gotta say, drama queen. He irritates me. I don't know what it is. He irritates me. He cries a lot, and I don't know. But his voice, I don't know if I like his voice either. We've heard that how many times before, and it just doesn't work. Felicia Barton, no one. I have this written down. If you guys notice me going back and forth, I wrote my reviews on this. But Felicia Barton, no one. Girl has the chops, I gotta say. I love this girl's voice. And I'm not too sure. She has this thing where she has the star quality to make it through, but I'm not too sure. Because there's heavy hitters in this round, so yeah. Scott McIntyre, I don't know what the song was. I couldn't understand, whatever. This guy has a genuine side, I gotta admit that. I really think he's amazing. His voice may not be as strong as others, but you can see there is an innocence about his voice, and which I really like. And I gotta say, girls, his brother is hot. Okay. Blonde hair and the gray blue eyes. Ooh, Lord have mercy. Kendall Beard is the next one. This one's for the girls. This girl stays true to herself, singing country, so which is a good thing. But she reminds me too much of Carrie Underwood a little, and I think she may make it to the next round. I'm not too sure, or she may make it to the wild card round. So we'll see. Jorge Nunez, Don't Let the Sun Go Down on Me. His voice was better than in previous editions, I gotta say. Very smart choice of song, because that is a very easy song to sing. Oh, well, for certain people. And I think he may make it to make it because of his voice, but also the crying factor. Because if you remember Jasmine Trias several years back, she started crying and she made it through and kicked off LaToya London.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And the last one, Lil Rounds. Okay, this Be Without You is her song. This girl has a big voice and her stage presence is amazing. Yeah. She said, put your hands up. She did all that. And just like Simon said, she's brilliant. And I personally think she did a good job on that song. And she really was put out there. And I think the song choice was fantastic for her. And a great choice. So my top three people will be Lil Rounds, Scott McIntyre, and Jorge Nunez. Those stood out for me, and I really think they will make it to the top rounds. Maybe Felicia Barton might make it, I'm not too sure, but those three, Lil, Scott, and Jorge, will make it to the top three. I want to know what you guys' thoughts are. Post it down there, post a video, subscribe, so if, hopefully I'm right, nope, that's not, that way, sorry, I keep getting this wrong, but subscribe on that side. I'm trying to rush here because I have to go to work. But I will catch you guys all later, my Cool Like That peeps. I really want to know what you guys think, so please comment. But please leave the gay connotations out there. We don't need to hear it. If you guys are going to make rude comments, don't put it down there. I want comments that's going to agree, disagree, not comments to bash me. Okay? So I will catch you guys all later. Love you guys. Mwah.